Hello friends, this is Durga again from ITVarsity, a one-stop shop to learn all the technologies. So as part of this video, let us define the problem statement for the data frames and design it and also implement it in this video itself. So the problem statement is to compute total revenue for each day. We will use same retail underscore DB where we have six tables: departments, categories, customers, products, orders and order items. And the problem statement is compute total revenue for each day. Earlier we have demonstrated how to compute average. As part of this video, we will see how to compute total revenue for each day. We will use a same retail DB and it has orders and order items. Those two tables needs to be joined. We'll be using data frames and data frame operations to provide the solution for this. And the way we need to implement is, now I'm getting into the design. The way you need to design this is, you have to have case classes, you have to have you have to use join operation on data frames, and you have to join the data, and also you have to use group operation, and then you have to use the aggregate operation, and then if you want to sort the data, you have to use the sort operation also. So this covers multiple data frame operations to accomplish the task. Now let's go to the implementation part. So first of all, we need to import the necessary packages, same way we have done earlier. I'll be using Scala interpreter itself to first validate that it works as expected. Okay, we need a Spark context, Spark configuration, SQL and SQL functions, and then we have to create case classes for orders as well as order items, both the data sets which we have to join. Once you create orders and order items, case classes, you have to create the conf object like this if you have to implement using a Scala IDE for Eclipse. It's better to set the master to local so that it runs in the local mode. And then we have to create the SC object, SQL context, and we have to set SQL shuffle partitions to 2, otherwise it will use 200 reducers and it will take very long time to run our join query. Okay, so here this parameter is very relevant. Our data set is very small. It doesn't make sense to use 200 reducers to run. SQL context is already available, that's why it is failed. We can ignore that. We don't need to worry about this because we already ran it before. We can pass it on. And then you can use the input path and output path. Here we should use output total revenue because we are trying to get the total revenue, not the average revenue. Let me fix that. So here we can see the input path and output path. Output path as output total revenue, and then we are also validating whether input path does not exist. If the output path already exists, we are trying to delete this. So this is the logic which we have been tested several times in the past in the previous applications. We are using the same thing over here. Okay, we don't need to worry much about this. Let me see if these three lines will be successful. If these three lines are successful, we just have to run this one. If the output path already exists, we just have to delete the output path. If the input path does not exist, we just have to println that input path does not exist and we have to return. Okay, I think when we try to run this here, we should not have the return statement. Let me fix that one. I will remove this validation of input path. It is not relevant at this time. We need to use that as part of the application, but not relevant at this time. Okay, now the fun part. We have to map the data for orders we have to split, and then we have to map it to the orders case class, and then we have to apply the 2DF to convert into a data frame. Same thing applies for the order items also, and we need to perform the casting operations, otherwise it will not work. So first function, we are trying to read the data from orders, apply the map function, split the orders by using comma as delimiter, create an array. So this A is nothing but array, and then using the elements in array, we are trying to create the orders object for each and every record, and then we are the output will be RDD, and we are trying to convert it into data frame here. Same is the case with order items. So we can run these two. Okay, and then what we need to do is we have to now implement using implement our solution to our problem statement using filter, join, group, aggregate, sort, etc. So first we need to filter the data because we are only concerned with the completed orders, and then we have to the filter needs to be applied on orders, on order status. If the order status is complete, then we have to consider only those records. And as part of the filter statement, we have to use 3 equals, not 2 equals or 1 equal, the way typically we do in other programming languages. Once orders are filtered, then we have to perform the join. And join is similar to the join in RDD. We have to give one data frame dot join and then the other data frame, but we need to define the order condition also. On RDD it's a different story. We have to first extract the key on which the data needs to be joined, and we have to join based on that key, whereas here we have to define the join condition also. In this case, the join condition is from orders filtered, we want to get the order ID, and we want to compare with order items, order item order ID. So that is the join condition for joining orders and order items in this case. Once the data is joined, again it will create a DF or data frame. All the data frame operation, all the operations on the data frames will result into another data frame. Okay, so now you have the joined data frame. And then we can apply the group by operation, and we want to group by order date because we want to get the total revenue for each day. And then we have to apply the aggregate function. Under aggregate function, you can define different predefined aggregate functions by Spark, such as sum, average, min, max, etc. So this aggregate function is trying to generate the revenue for each day based on the group by condition order date, and then I want to sort the data, hence I am giving sort data frame operation here. After doing all these things, I want to convert it into RDD so that I don't have the circular brackets and unnecessary information, and then apply save as text file to output path. Without converting to RDD, it is not straightforward to apply the save as text file. You have to use RDD data frame based operations to save it as text file. In this case, I am converting to RDD, and then I am applying the save as text file. Otherwise, you will be able to save as table and store into the database or something else. If you have to save as text file, the most simpler way of doing that doing it is by converting to RDD and then apply the save as text file. That's why we have RDD here, and then we have save as text file here. So let us do one after the other at a time. First, we are filtering the orders only for completed orders. We can preview the data the way we have seen earlier, orders filtered dot show, and you can see we are only getting the completed orders. And then we can join orders and order items. Okay, and we can actually say orders join dot print schema to get the schema of orders join, You can see that it has order ID, order date, order customer ID, order status, and then order item columns such as ID, order ID, product ID, quantity, subtotal, price, etc. Okay, and you can also say show orders join dot show to preview the data. It will return all 4 plus 6 columns. It should have returned 10 columns. I don't know why the join is not returning any values here. Let me check. Order items df dot show. It is returning the data. Then why orders join is not working? Order item, order ID. Let me see. Order items df print schema. Yes, order item, order ID. Let me run this and see if it works or not. Probably the preview command might not be working. And also it is using 200 shuffles. There is something wrong. Something is wrong with this. I am killing this one. And I am launching it again. And then let me copy paste all these things. I removed this, but I didn't refresh this page. That's why it is still showing input path doesn't exist condition. Okay, now I am actually applying the map functions to convert into data frames. Okay, now let us see these things. Orders join dot show. Now it is working as expected. So there is nothing wrong in the code, and for some reason it didn't work in the past. Now let us run this. The complete transformation where we are actually grouping by the data, aggregating, sorting, and then converting it into RDD, and then we are saving it as file to the output path, and our output path is this location. Okay, and it is successful. There are no errors. You can see it here. Now if you go to this and paste that output path and ls-ltr, you can see the data which it just created, and then cat part star, and you can see the data is sorted properly from 2013 July 25th till 2014 July 24th, and for each day we got the total revenue written to the output path. So this is how you can use the data frame operations themselves to apply the transformations which are applicable on structured data. If you have the data on which structure is defined, and you can apply the standard operations such as filter, group, sort, join, etc., you can consider data frame operations and you can use those things as part of your application. That being said, as part of this the next video, we will see how this code can be used to create a object and then compile it into a jar file, ship the jar file to the remote cluster and validate and run that jar file on the remote cluster. All those details will be seen as part of the next video. That being said, I hope you are enjoying the content. If you like this video, please click on the like button. If you want to provide the feedback, please use the comment section of the video. If you want to discuss, if you have to provide the rating, please give me the full rating. If you think otherwise, please let me know so that I can improve on my content going forward. That being said, thank you. Bye.